Welcome back to IT Free Training's free Windows 7 training course. In this video, I will look at backing up your Windows 7 system. With any computer system, you should perform regular backups to protect your data from loss. Regardless of how new or old your computer system is and how much you paid for it, hardware does fail from time to time, taking your data with it. Windows 7 comes with backup software called Backup and Restore. This software will not only back up your data files, but can also back up your operating system. It achieves this by using two different methods. To back up the complete system, Backup and Restore creates what is called a system image. A system image has all the files and folders on the hard disk, including the operating system files and program files. It is basically a complete copy of your Windows 7 hard disk. The system image can also be used in what is referred to as a bare metal recovery. This is when you restore the operating system to another computer with different hardware. For example, if your laptop was stolen and you purchased a new one with different hardware, you can restore Windows 7 to the new laptop with a system image and Windows will detect all the hardware changes. The disadvantage of a system image is that you cannot restore individual files. It is either all or nothing. The backup itself is stored in a VHD file. A workaround to restore single files from a system image is to mount the VHD file in the operating system and then extract the files you need from it with Windows Explorer. This is not the most user-friendly way of restoring the files from a backup for the average user. To have a more user-friendly backup, Windows 7 also allows you to backup individual files and folders. This gives you a simple way of backing up documents and user files. The advantage with this method is that the backups tend to be smaller, and thus you can keep more backup revisions. You could, for example, run a backup each day of the week and restore files from any day of the week. Windows 7 will automatically manage the space allocated for backups, maximizing the amount of backup history your computer can hold. So why does backup and restore need two different systems? System images tend to be quite large in nature since they contain all the files on your hard disk. They also contain system files and other information about your system. For example, they contain the boot sector from your hard disk, basically everything you need to recover your system. So considering how big system images are, some administrators may create a manual system image every 6 months and put it somewhere safe. The file and folder backup, unlike the system image backup, allows you to choose which files and folders to back up. You could choose to back up the system and program files in this backup. However, this backup does not support a full Windows 7 recovery. If your hard disk were to crash, you would only be able to recover individual files, not the complete system. How would you use the two backup types together? If you had a complete hard disk failure 3 months after you completed a system image backup, you could use the system image to recover the operating system. Once done, use the file and folder backup to recover your data files. Having said this, any software that was installed after the image backup was complete will have to be reinstalled. Windows updates, new device drivers, and additional software can be reinstalled quite easily. Since the file and folder backup contains all the most recent document changes, you have not lost anything that can't be recovered. In some cases, you may not even want to restore the operating system. You may be quite happy to install a fresh copy of Windows 7 and start again as long as your documents have been backed up. You can see how having two backup types gives you a lot of options. In this video, I will look at configuring a backup in Windows 7 and restoring individual files and folders. In the next video, I will look at how to restore the whole system using a system image. With Backup and Restore in Windows 7, you can back up your data to a number of different destinations. Each option has its own advantages and disadvantages. When considering which option to use, you need to consider what you want to achieve. In the simplest case, a user will want to restore a file or folder when they accidentally delete it or the files become corrupt. If you want to recover data that has been lost because of a fire or theft, you need to store the backup in a secure location. The first backup media supported by Backup and Restore is a second internal hard disk. Backing up to an internal hard disk is the fastest option available for Windows Backup and Restore. The problem with internal hard disks is that they are not always easy and quick to remove. For this reason, they are not good candidates for regular off-site storage. Some computers have eSATA connections. This will allow you to externally connect a hard disk to your computer. This is one way to use an internal hard disk, but have the freedom to easily remove the hard disk to take it off-site. An internal hard disk also gives you the ability to restore the system if the primary hard disk were to fail. The next option is to use an external hard disk. An external hard disk tends to be slower than an internal hard disk. External hard disks are drives that are connected by connections like USB and FireWire. The difference between these devices and the eSATA is that an eSATA drive is treated like a standard SATA hard disk. The operating system essentially sees eSATA hard disks as another internal SATA hard disk, even though the hard disk is external to the computer. The advantage of external hard disks is that they are easy to connect and to disconnect from the system and transport. You only have to plug them into Windows and they will be installed automatically for you. External hard disks don't like being bumped around too much, so having them transported to your off-site location on a daily basis may reduce the lifespan of the drive. However, if you just want to transport it to your fireproof safe on-site, they work really well. The next option is optical media, which is very cheap nowadays and can easily be taken off-site. The media does not take up much room, so you could easily take it home in a briefcase and is quite resistant to forces like being dropped. If your data is larger than the optical disk, Windows will span the data over multiple disks. Optical disks are good for a cheap, once-off backup of your system, but keep in mind that optical media does have a lifespan. After a few years, the media does start to become less reliable. The disadvantage of optical disks is that system image cannot be included with a regularly scheduled backup. As you will see later in the demonstration, when you configure Backup and Restore, you can configure a schedule for backup to include a system backup. With optical media, you need to run a system image separately. Lastly, optical media does not support incremental backups for system image backups. Incremental means that backups performed after the first full backup only save the changes. In order to support this feature, the destination media must be on NTFS, which optical disks are not. The next type of media is USB flash drives. These are small and easy to carry, but the capacity is not that great. Removable media like USB flash drives do not support system image backup using the scheduling feature. With the limited amount of space on the flash drive, it is unlikely that you would want to store a system image backup on the flash drive anyway. Lastly, you can store your backup on a network share, such as a network-attached storage device, or on a file server. The speed of the backup will be determined by how fast your network is. The disadvantage of a network backup is that it only supports one system image backup using the scheduling feature. Media, like hard disks, can store multiple system images in the one file, given multiple backups to restore them. In order to use Backup and Restore to a network location, you need to be running Windows 7 Professional or above. Regardless of which media you select, it can be any size, assuming it is large enough to hold the data that you are backing up. The larger the media, the more revisions of each file that it will be able to hold. With Windows Backup and Restore, there are some options which are not supported. First, you cannot backup Windows to the same volume as Windows. Also, you cannot backup to a recovery partition or a partition that has been encrypted with BitLocker. Lastly, Windows Backup and Restore does not support tape drives. That's all the basic theory for the Windows Backup. I will now switch to my Windows 7 computer and demonstrate how to use Windows Backup. To access the Backup and Restore settings in Windows 7, open the Start menu and go to All Programs, Maintenance, and select Backup and Restore. No backup has been configured on this computer yet. To configure one, select the option Set Up Backup. Windows will automatically detect the available local destinations the backup can be stored. In this case, I have the option for the DVD drive and a second internal hard disk. If you want to save the backup to a network location, select the option Save on a Network. Here you can enter in the details for the network share that you want to save the backup to. In this case, I will cancel out of here and select the option for the second internal hard disk. On this screen, you can let Windows decide which files to backup or select the second option to choose your own options. I will choose the second option so that we can see which options are available. Windows by default will backup the user profiles on the system. Things like the items in the recycle bin and the temporary files are automatically excluded by the backup. By default, items like program files are also not included in the backup, as shown here. Windows Backup and Restore assumes that you will backup the program and system files using a system image. The tick box, Include a System Image of Drives, creates a system image. A system image contains all the files on the drive, including the system and program files. The system image can be used to recover the complete system if the hard drive fails. The system image does not support single file restores. If I were using a media like optical media, this option would be grayed out, but could be performed manually using the Backup and Restore control panel. On the next and final screen of the wizard, select the option Change Schedule. You are free to run the backup as often as you want. The backup does use system resources when it runs, so if your computer is on all the time, schedule the backup to run when you are not using it. Once the wizard is complete, the first backup will run. If you want more details about how the backup is running, press the View Details button. The first backup will take the longest, as all files need to be backed up. Once the first backup is complete, Windows Backup and Restore will do incremental changes when possible. The backup does take a long time to run, so I will pause the video and return shortly. Once the backup is complete, I can go back to Backup and Restore and get some information about how much space the backup is using. If I select the option Manage Space, I can get more information about how much space is being used and for which type of files. Windows Backup and Restore will automatically remove old backups when they are no longer needed. To see which backups are available, press the button View Backups. The amount of backups that Windows will hold will ultimately be determined by how much space you have for backups and how often the backup runs and how many changes happen on your hard disk between the backups. On the previous screen, there are also options for system image. The system image contains a copy of all the files on the hard disk, so it is generally larger than the file backup. The system and program files only change when new programs are installed or Windows updates are applied. For this reason, you may want to keep only one copy of the system image. Having only one copy of the system image will save hard disk space and thus allow you to keep more regular file backups. Having more file backups means that you have more restore history to choose from when restoring files. If I exit out of here and open Windows Explorer and open the E drive, you can see all the backup files that were created by Windows Backup and Restore. Drilling down through the folders, there is a folder with the backup in it with the file name containing the timestamp of when the backup was run. These files are the backup files. If you were to access these files on another computer using Windows Backup and Restore, you would be able to use Restore Files in Windows Backup and Restore on the other computer. going back to the backup and restore interface. To restore a file or folder, press the button Restore My Files. Here you can search for files, or if you know the file or folders that you want, you can select the file or folder. As you can see, using Backup and Restore to backup and restore files is easy when Windows 7 is running. But how do you recover the system when you have a hard disk crash? To find out how, see our next video, Recovering Windows 7 from a System Image. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training. For the rest of the course, please see our YouTube channel or webpage.